weird thing was that when I showed Nothing Bad Can Happen, one of the first feedbacks were like, oh, how is it possible that a woman makes a feature like this, you know? I thought women don't like this kind of stuff. And I was like, what? I'm coming from a, like, musical-wise, a metal background, so I really like the dark side, you know? And horror, for example, is something which is very human, I think. It's a fear, and this is coming directly from your heart, and a woman knows fear very well. There was, for example, this horror film Night of the Living Dead, and there was this zombie with like going like and the woman, she's running but falling, and she jumps into a car, but the car hits a tree, and then she stays in the car, and the zombie's like knocking on the windows and everything. And I was like, this is so ridiculous, why is this woman so stupid, you know? And I always felt like it, of course I won't repeat this kind of storytelling about women, you know, I want to show women in strong positions. If it's a female lead, it's okay, and if it's a male lead, it's okay as well. I can and want to do everything I'm interested in, and I don't have this barriers in my head.
Yeah. Hey, Tee, kannst du ein paar frische Bier holen zum Kühlschrank? Bitte?
Aber bisschen komisch ist er schon, ne?
Der macht stundenlang so Papierzeug.
Das ist immer.
Hey, Entschuldigung. Danke.
Hey, Mr. T, was glaubst du? Was macht so ein richtiges Känguru, wenn du ihm auf dem Schwanz trittst, ja?
Mr. T, ich hau mich weg.
Wegspringen.
Falsch. Boxen.
When I started to work on Nothing Bad Can Happen, I had just a kind of a web article about the story, and it was kind of similar to what the film is about now, but there are also certain differences. But the main story was a young boy was slaved by a family, and I researched a little more, and I found out that he actually was very religious. And I was reading Dostoevsky's Idiot, and in the center of the book is a very religious man, but because he is so positive and also naive, he starts to provoke a circle of violence around him, and he's becoming the center of it. And I thought that is provocative, because even though everybody is like going to church and putting this cross to the wall with a dead Jesus Christ, actually having a process of sacrificing yourself in front of a camera is very painful, and people would not like to see that, even though it's so Christian what he does, and so pure. And that was the base of the film. There was this moment in the real story where this protagonist was forced to eat something he didn't like to eat. They actually did a lot of crazy things to him, but I felt this is something at least I react on in a really very direct way, you know. I see, like, for example, when I watched Pasolini's Salò, I felt very sick and I had to run to the bathroom, and it was like I felt the violence inside my body. And I thought, well, we see so many movies where there is violence in it. So maybe I take a scene which is very subtle and very normal in a way, like a dinner, but the boy has to eat something which is rotten, and your body reacts immediately, and sure, the audience will react as well. So maybe this is a moment where we can really link to the pain. I would say what And I have, of course, no proof on it, but I think since Nothing Bad Can Happen was really successful, I think a man would get more job offers or interesting opportunities afterwards. I think I was really lucky, and I got a lot of attention, and I think I used it. I think the discrimination still is not so obvious, and now is a moment where a lot of women get attention and where they start to be to help each other and go into associations, and we really need, I think, to use the power now and not give up, you know, and be really demanding, really saying, like, I deserve to become a famous filmmaker, and I deserve to get my movie funded, and I deserve to get a $5 million dollar production as much as a man does, and I can totally handle it. And I think we still need to work on this a lot, but it's getting better now.